Thank you. This is a presentation about the paper that we published earlier this year. As neural networks are increasingly employed to solve complex tasks, the need to provide explanations to their behavior becomes even more pressing. As it turns out, neural networks only use subsymbolic representations based on a high dimensional Euclidean space. So this has no obvious associated declarative meaning. So we're left without the direct human interpretable indication of why a specific output was produced. And what we claim is that to justify the output of a neural network, we need a language containing human understandable concepts and meaningful relationships between those concepts. And without such language, we cannot even begin to attempt to express the comprehensible justifications. For example, if we were to justify how a neural network classifies strains of some particular type, we would likely expect such justifications to use concepts such as passenger train, freight train, so on and so forth. And this is where KR comes to the rescue. We can use an ontology language to define the necessary language at the right level of abstraction to adequately convey the justifications for the output of a given neural network. So let's assume that we have a train neural network for which we'd like to justify its output, and we have some ontology that encodes the domain of discourse and the existing background knowledge about that domain. Now, the big question is, how do we relate both systems? Our main hypothesis is that if human-defined ontological concepts are relevant to the task of the trained neural network, then we should somehow be able to relate them to the representations encoded in the model of that network, the activations of the neurons. For example, if a neural network were trained to identify mixed trains, then we should be able to relate the representations encoded in the network's model with concepts like passenger car, freight wagon, given that usually they are concepts used to define these mixed trains. This somehow resembles ideas from research conducted in the field of neurosciences, where ensembles of neurons and how they respond to stimuli have been investigated to comprehend what information they encode. So we propose to establish mappings from the values of the activations produced by the neurons of a neural network to concepts from a chosen ontology through what we call the mapping networks. So these are networks that will be responsible for mapping between the activations of the main network, so its internal representation, and concepts from an ontology. Then, when feeding input to a neural network, we can observe through the use of these mapping networks whether the corresponding concepts were identified or not. And by extracting these concepts, we actually acquire additional knowledge about the neural network's input. Okay, so using then logic-based reasoning methods together with the ontology and these observations, then we can create justifications for the neural network's output. There would be essentially minimal sets of axioms from the ontology that together with the observations would entail the output of the neural network. So in this paper, we then conduct several experiments using a synthetic set of images of trains to assess whether actually this method makes any sense. So we first tried to show the correctness of our main hypothesis, namely whether relevant concepts are somehow encoded in the model of the neural network. And our experiments show that we're typically able to extract concepts that are ontologically relevant to the output of the neural network with fewer examples and achieving higher accuracy than non-relevant concepts. So it means that if we try to actually map relevant concepts from the neural network, it's easy. If we were trying to map concepts which make no sense or play no role in that classification, then it turns out to be hard. Furthermore, we show evidence that using the internal activations of the neural network when extracting those concepts, it's better than if we were to train new networks altogether from the original data to extract those concepts. So somehow this shows that these concepts are really encoded in the internal state of the neural network. Then, of course, one very important question is whether these extracted concepts are what we expect them to be, or whether they're just based on spurious correlations between the input data. And we were able to show using heat maps and other methods that they actually embody the kinds of, they're looking at the right parts of the images when they are extracted. Finally, we also looked at the reasoning part and the justifications. And in using this data set that we use for our experiment, we were able to come up with correct justifications in most cases. So this somehow shows evidence that this method actually works. There's a whole lot more I would have liked to talk about, but we're running out of time. So I invite you to come to our poster session if you'd like to discuss this further with us. So thank you for your attention.